This time around, I'd like to show you some stuff based on the bridge section, or the chorus section, if you will, from a tune called Sevens on my Erotic Cakes album. And it's this kind of thing. But I'd like to kind of simplify it a bit and hopefully make it more useful for what you might do in your own music. The genesis of that lick was trying to find a new way to play a major seventh arpeggio. And I started out by looking at it two notes per string. I guess with E flat major seven, so I'd start there. So you've got that network of notes and you're doing this the whole time, which is always fun. And then I figured it might be interesting to split that up. So for each string, my tapping hand is doing the higher note and the regular fretting hand is doing the lower note. So that then gave me... And then I thought, okay, if the notes are split up like that, then I don't have to play them in order anymore and I can get more of a sequence rather than just highest note to the lowest note. And I thought, I wonder what that will sound like. And you don't really get that sound any other way. Every note is on a fresh string. So if you experiment with how long the fingertips spend on their allotted note, you can get a really staccato sound or more of a solid. So one of the main things is to make sure you're hammering as hard as possible, especially with this rubbish finger, which is God's little joke at our expense. 3.5 fingers on each hand, but... the more confidently you can hit those, the better this stuff will sound. So I'm using, because I'm weird, I've got the pick tucked away in the index finger the whole time, because I never know when there might be an emergency and I might need to pick a note, so it's just there. So I'm using the second and fourth fingers on that hand, and indeed on this hand. Now I have the string damper there. Often I forget to put it on. So to keep the noise to a minimum, I'm using index finger just as a blank. It's just resting lightly on those strings. And I'm just hammering again with the fourth finger and the second finger. So that's the basic shape there. You might want to check that you can do that. And then if we move on to the next set of strings, there's a similar thing. Now I'd be using the second and third fingers. So exactly the same idea, but now the notes are... That is a fourth interval instead of a fifth with each hand. And then you can move down to here. For some reason, I now use the second and third fingers on this hand. I think so that I can remember my bearings, and if I have to go back to the top string, I don't have to readjust too much. The wrist position hasn't changed too drastically. And with this hand, it's still the fourth finger and the second finger, purely for anti-noise reasons. So we've now got a whole arpeggio that looks like that. You could continue, it gets a bit hairy there, because you've got two fingers on the same fret tapping different strings. It's a bit of a tap dance there. You have to hammer this note and then get it right out of the way when this finger comes on. Otherwise, they'll collide with each other. And generally, a finger is fatter than the distance between two strings, so it will end in tears if you're not careful. But you can see how the pattern would repeat until you run out of strings. Now, before I turn that into the actual lick from Sevens, which is not important because that already exists, that's mine. You need to come up with yours. It's interesting to have a look at all the different stuff you can do just by moving one hand up or down, because you're just playing two notes of the arpeggio in terms of musical formula with this hand and the other two notes with this hand. So I've got the root and the fifth there, and then the third and the seventh there. So I could move this hand down a fret and it's a minor seventh now, or I could move it up and get this suspended sound. It's just one motor skill, and if you've trained your fingers to do that and they're in time and the notes are all loud, you might as well see how much mileage you can get out of that basic technique. Here's the final version of this idea in my world. This is as far as I took it. And the real twist here is because my tune is in a 7/4 time signature, hence the imaginative name. It kind of starts going down and then it reverses back on itself a little bit and then continues going back down. So it's the highest pair of strings, then the middle, then the highest again, then the middle, then the lowest, then the middle, and then the lowest again.